What's up, guys? So, picking up a Mazda for someone I know. It's been sitting here for like 11 years, from my understanding. So if you're curious as to why I was backing up like this, it's because I want to put air in the tires. Let's see what the hell I got here. Got that legacy metal polish. As you can see, I'm making some type of progress with the organization of the box. I have more cut out. Oh, this is the problem I had the last time. Crap. Alright, so I gotta reroute this setup. Because the airline attachment is in the back corner. So I gotta reroute that and get a roll up or something, or just move the whole thing up to the outside. I don't know. I'd like to put a roll up on that, a roll up hose, so I don't have to worry about this anymore. And this hose is a pain when it's cold because it gets hard, but it's convenient. So I do have a portable, but the problem with the portable is that it's portable, is battery operated, and you know, by the time I fill up one or two tires, I can do all four with a hose. Smell that sucks. I got a lot of good meat on them. The car's been sitting for like 11 years. So who knows what's gonna happen with this car. I'm hoping that I can put air in tires, get it to roll easily, because they just put a new well pump there and I can't go anywhere near it. So I'm gonna go up the driveway, angle the bed this way a little bit, put a snatch block and just hopefully get it out that way. I'm hoping to get the wheels free and rolling, and the brakes and rotors hopefully aren't stuck. Mm-hmm. bead's not broken, so that's good. Don't want to fill it up by having dirt in the tires, in the rim. And I hope that this clay is not in the actual like seal area of the rim. It's pushing outwards, which is good. Wrap up the hose, hook this bad boy up, and see if it will roll. So, I'm going to leave that like that. So this is the problem with these hoses like this, that they're like that plastic instead of being like a rubber hose. it's cold. So like right now it's like 40 degrees out and the plastic is just like hard, and it like, you know, stiffens up and it's a pain in the butt to wrap up. So you need to upgrade the hose or put a like a hose reel. I'm probably gonna put a hose reel on the side. I think it's nicer that way. This is annoying. And these are Cable Raptor. You can get these at, I think I got them at Lowe's. Alright. Let's see what we can do. Got the keys. This vehicle does have a shift lock override on it. So we should be able to just get it right into neutral. Angle everything over, try and get the bed onto the dirt. But I don't want the truck on the dirt. You can keep, you can see, that should work as long as the car rolls. Go PTO on. Okay, so. Up. I'm probably going to use two snatch blocks and I'll show you why in a second. Grabbing the control arm. So much mud and dirt under there. All right, so we are set up now. These are the things I hate about these stupid clips. See that? They get bent and then they'll go this way and very easily you'll lose a bridle. So this, I'll have to force it back from the side, grab a pair of pliers, twist it. Those clips are cheap, they're like $3, man. If you gotta change it, change it. Trust me when I tell you,
Don't be cheap.
Change it. That stupid little thing right there can cost you a lot of money. So we'll get rid of that one. Use two snatch blocks. I know people are gonna say, oh, you don't have to, you can use one snatch block. Yes, you can, but I'm gonna use two, and I will show you why I will use two. So one snatch block is gonna be pulling here to try to keep that going this way away from the well. All right, so the problem with that is that when this cable gets tight, now you're pulling this way. So as you start to get tight on the cable, it's gonna start wrapping, but start shifting over fast. So it won't be wrapped up tight. It'll be wrapping over this way, and you'll have big gaps and you'll mess up the cable. All right? So that's why you'll use two snatch blocks. All right? So I'll show you, you know, how I do it and how it works for me. Probably come up here. This one. Okay, so now I'll show you why I use two snatch blocks. Now everything that I do is just the way that I do it. Alright, I'm not telling you that this is the way Wreckmaster shows you, or you know, some type of towing school, how they show you. This is just the way I do it. This is the way it works for me. So I'm showing you how I do it. Again, you know, this is how I do it. Many, you know, people do things their own way, you know, which is fine. And me personally, I do things my way, which works for me. So my videos, when I do them, I'm not rushing because I'm not in a rush. You know, I'm not in a rush, and I'm teaching people. You know, so when I teach people, I like to take my time explaining things. I gotta change this cable because it's got flat spots. It's always giving me issues. So now, I'll show you why it's important to use two snatch blocks. Every wrecker, rollback, should always have two to three snatch blocks. So look at the pull, how it is now. So that's gonna keep the line centered. That'll keep the line centered and wrap it up nice on the drum. This side will allow me to change the direction of the pull. So that's why I like to use two snatch blocks. So this way the drum is not getting all messed up. Now let's put the car in neutral and see if we can get it to roll. If not, we'll have to work with it and adjust everything. But it is what it is, because we will get the job done. Now if you hear me sniffling, it's because it's cold out. This weather lately has been on some seriousness. One day it's warm, one day it's cold. Oh, spider webs everywhere. So put the key in there. Hey, you're supposed to unlock, man. Oh, really? Let me see something. Nope. Okay, release is not working. That's always fun. Is this really like, I could feel pinned in here. Huh. I've never seen one that actually has teeth inside of it. Not teeth, but those pins to unlock it. Oh, we got it. I had me nervous. This, are you kidding me right now? Come on. The key, okay, good. Holy crap, this actually has a key that you have to turn to unlock it, then turn it back and get that like that.
Can
Hello.
You do me a huge favor?
Yes.
Can you call my phone?
Call your phone? Yeah, of course.
I don't know where to
know it. Take it off camera so nobody sees it.
I'm sorry.
No, I'm lifting up the camera so nobody sees your number.
Oh, okay. I'm gonna leave this door for a minute.
Yep. We got tape deck, CD changer in the back.
Thank you.
You got it?
I got it.
Okay. You're welcome.
I'm gonna shut this.
Okay. All right. Okay, so now it's in neutral. We'll put the key here, turn it forward so the steering wheel is unlocked. Alright, well, let's see what happens. I'll break a little bit. Easy there, buddy. Well, it's rolling, so that's a good sign. Very good sign, look at that. It's always nice when they just roll. Probably break down a little bit more because I just don't want it to start rolling. But you see how it's like, you know, nice and keeping it nice and straight. One side's rolling, the other side's stuck. We'll let the parking brake off. Oh, ain't much I can do about that. Probably gonna have to WD-40 that or whack it. Trap one wheel first, so I'll put a safety chain before getting in it to put it in park. The drop. Okay. This wheel here is the one that's gonna give me the problem. See the parking brake? Looks like it's stuck there. Oh, let's see if we can get it loose. Thank you. Sometimes you hit them and they'll loosen up. Sometimes they won't. Trying to see if I can get it to roll. Oh, there we go. Got it. Yeah, when I picked it up, it was stuck and it wouldn't roll. And then just now, it was like hitting it back and forth, gave it a little bit of BB blaster.
Yeah.
And then the problem is the dirt. Like, it's locked, so I need like concrete or something stiff.
Yeah.
You know? That's why I left the bed like that a little bit, so it'll like kind of have to climb up it.
This boy here, he finds the most damn shit, doesn't he?
Sorry to bust your bubble. Sorry to bust your bubble.
That's alright. Our dreams can't always come true, right? Well, buddy, take care.
Alright, man, have a good one. Yeah, so we got the wheel freed up, which is good because now he's gotta, you know, move it, pull it, whatever, it'll roll versus having to be stuck there dragging it. Usually works easier when you're on asphalt or like concrete where you get better grip for the wheel to like grip so it can like kind of turn or be forced to turn. And on dirt, it doesn't work out the best. All right. That's it, put all this crap away, take my pictures. Alright, I have it on fit. That's okay. Alright. Alright, so we're done. Let's take my pictures, get out of here. And as always, guys, thanks for watching and hanging out. Don't forget to give the video a thumbs up, like, share, and subscribe if you like the content. And I'll see you on the next one.